Operation Kingslayer. Listen up. Our field of operation is Bolivia. Dense jungles, freezing mountains, and salt flats. If you don't watch your...
Hola, compañeros. God, I'm gonna get in so much trouble. Blonde haired, blue eyed French Canadian dude talking like a Latino. I'm like, they hate mail. Anyway, I am Mighty Mr. Mustache, the mightiest mustache in the universe, back with a little more Ghost Recon action. We finished off Itaqua, at least as much as I was planning on doing. And today we are going to try and move over to the next area. We've taken out the first of these underbosses over here, Yuri, La Yuri and El Polito, these crazy in-love torturers, just to give you an idea of the direction that they're going in, the kind of fun they want us to have. So I think the next place we'll go to, should we go to Parque Nacional de Agua Verde or Ocoro? So I flipped the coin and I said Ocoro. So let's go and do some of Ocoro. If you want to see me do less, maybe not get 100% of everything, just do the story mission, let me know in the comment. If you really do want to see me do everything, let me know in the comments. I'm happy to do as much or as little as you guys like. If you're enjoying watching it, it's good enough for me. Squad skill, what do I have? Okay. How about drone skill, item skill? Let's get the parachute, because why not? It's fun. I know I said I would rush the squad skills, but I have more than enough skill points to make that happen. I don't really care about the rest of these necessarily. I didn't find most of them were overly necessary until the last parts of the game. Drone skills are always good. Longer battery, better range, faster speed, stealth. But I'll worry about that after I run through squad. And right now what I'm looking for is food parcels and medication so that I can level these things up. And of course, just plain old leveling up in order to have high enough character level to get those third ranks. Yeah, let's take a little Volkswagen minibus here. Volkswagen, you owe me some money for the plug. Yeah, like that would ever happen. Ran over a rebel. Oops. Oh, seriously, boys, I didn't mean it. How am I getting over here now? Let's see. Across a bridge somewhere. Okay, here. Let's head to Ocoro right there. Corriero. Alright. Let's just drive through the countryside a bit in our Volkswagen minibus. Tell you, Volkswagen, I will shill for you. I don't know why. I don't even like them. Years and years spent as a tow truck driver has taught me that there's a special place in hell for the people who design the Volkswagens. Including, mechanics or the designers of the mechanics of the Volkswagens, because they put all these parts in completely inaccessible places. Any mechanic will tell you it's just the devil to work on one. And they're designed by these brilliant German engineers, who I guess want to make you pay for your enjoyment of your vehicle with incredibly frustrating times and the need for specialized tools that no sane person would use or could afford. And so I'm going to spend a few minutes here just demolishing this poor vehicle, and then I'm going to go and pick up another one over here. Right, let's just go grab a car from over here and see what we can do. Oh, better a truck. Yaha! Thank you, mine friends. I'm stealing your truck.
Move out. I'm on your six.
Come on, kids. I don't want to run you over. I'm not that big a monster. Okay, here we go. We're on the road properly. Let's just see how long it takes us to drive over to Okoro and get started. Let's see. John can follow a GPS. He really can. There's a DLC coming out, and I put a little video talking about it. It will be out in a couple of days, on Tuesday, actually. And a patch came out, which apparently fixed a few bug issues. That's about 90% of that. They've also fixed a bit of the chat options. People made it less repetitive. If you listen to the radio, which I don't because I don't feel like getting copyright striked again, but if you do listen to the radio, you'll notice that it has more options. Can I get into Okoro from here? Okoroito. Yeah, let's just go across here then. Good deal. Oh, it's not there. It's farther down. And here we go. I see a checkpoint or a watchtower of some kind. These trucks are actually pretty handy to drive, at least on the bigger roads. But I'm not going to beat that. Okay. Let's see what it says. Corn and beef farming. Its main town is Campoan. And,
This is Nomad. We're on the ground in Okoro. What have you got for us?
Okoro is the heart of cocaine production in Bolivia. The network there was built by El Yayo and predates Santa Blanca by more than a decade. When El Yayo joined the cartel and became the boss of production, he handed Okoro off to his grandson, who goes by the name El Emissario.
You're okay.
The Emissary.
Most of his time outside the province, rubbing shoulders with politicians in Sucre and greasing the wheels for the cartel. Not really his job, but the guy's something of a charmer, and he figures this is the best way to make his grandfather proud. El Yayo lets it slide so long as Okoro continues to produce. Fact is, the network is so well established that it pretty much runs itself. El Emisario's assistant handles the rest. Get in there, gather intel on Okoro's production sites, and start fucking things up. That'll put pressure on El Emisario to come back to Okoro and get things back on track before Granddad finds out. When that happens, we grab him and use him to get to El Yayo.
Okay.
Getting an upload from Bowman. Looks like she's got some intel on El Emisario.
Cool, let's watch this little video. This is kind of neat. I know that it's a little boring not to hear me chit-chatting, but maybe it's not.
Gonzalo Yano, a.k.a. El Emisario, the Emissary. Yayo taught Emisario everything he knows. How to produce the best polvo in all of South America, how to maintain relationships with the local Bolivians, and most importantly, how to serve your Santa Blanca masters. Emisario looks up to Yayo, would do anything to honor him, to make him proud. Which is exactly what makes El Emisario the perfect target. His greatest fear is shaming his grandfather. If we hit his coke operation in Okoro, he'll come running back to fix things. That's when we grab him. With a little luck, he'll give us everything we need to know about dear old grandpa.
Well, all right then. What a vicious looking old bugger that man is, isn't he? Okay, so where do we go first? Well, right there, look at that. I happen to like driving these trucks. They're a little floaty, but on well-paved roads and the like, the beefiness of them makes them easier to keep on a straight track. For all that they seem to rock and jerk back and forth, they're much easier to steer. They take their turns wide, but if you do hit something, they're, I tell you, they're tanky as anything. Again, probably the best is still to jump in a helicopter, but in the more tough areas, helicopters are not always a good idea. There are so many anti-aircraft sites. Let's just grab one of these guys if we can. There's some intel over here. I'm gonna see, maybe. Is this intel? Yes, it is. Look at that. What do I want? Supply raids, rebel ops, skill points. Let's start with supply raids this time. I got skill points last time. I have lots of them. And if I pop in here, let's go grab a lieutenant.
Familiarize yourselves with Bowman's briefing on Santa Blanca's coke production pipeline.
People at the top are El Yayo and La Gringa. Yayo's Bolivian, an ex-cocalero turned cocaine producer. Gringa seems to be a disgraced chemist. She used to work for an NGO here in Bolivia.
Quejases, you got a tip on the cartel in the area? Gracias.
Nice. Okay, so you can just ask some people for intel. He's actually not a bad guy. Ooh, a new video's available.
El Yayo was born amidst the Bolivian coca. His mother carried him on her back until he was old enough to go to work for himself. For decades, Yayo picked the leaves, fingers blistered, back aching, feet bleeding. But never, in all that time, did he once extract the alkaloids to make cocaine. To Yayo, the coca leaf was an ancient tradition, going back 8,000 years. A medicine, a culture, una planta sagrada. Of course, the Americanos had a different opinion. They called it Plan Dignidad, the dignity plan. Although Yayo was no more than a farmer, un cocalero, his world was left in ruins. With no other means available, he was forced to do the one thing that he vowed never to do. He was forced to produce cocaine. In the end, the Americans' efforts to stop cocaine production created one of the greatest cocaine producers to ever live.
Well, sometimes, no matter how hard you try, you don't get anything good done. And there are always casualties in a war. Especially a war on drugs. You're talking about the kind of money that buys and sells entire governments. They're not just going to roll over and let you do what you want. Nice. Let's take these guys out if we can.
We got civilians dangerously close. Check your targets before you shoot.
Yo, two cartel gunmen.
Target marked. Keep an eye on your background. I got a target carrying submachine guns.
I got two Sicarios. Okay, angle close to the helo.
Cool. Alright, we're gonna be stealthy like the shadow of a whisper. Yes, I actually said the shadow of a whisper.
Hey, we got a narco over there, next to the container.
Whoa.
Back it up, they're gonna see you.
Whoa. I almost got spotted. Really? Where's the medal? There it is! Look at that! Alright, so cool. Here we go. We are in Okoro now. We're gonna take this helicopter, go grab some intel, start the mission, start the storyline. We'll pick up things as we come across them. I'm not gonna make a particular effort to go after all of the skill points or the weapon upgrades and the like. Unless you want to see a very particular thing. I don't see it as a necessity. Yes, you can pick up weapons from enemies who drop them on the ground, but you don't get them as part of your permanent loadout if you do. What you do get is that weapon until it runs out of ammo. If you want a weapon as a permanent part of your loadout, and yes, every weapon that drops on the ground eventually can be found in the game as part of a loadout, you have to go and find them as weapon drops, like the ones you've seen before. So let's just grab this helicopter, head for this first. Oh, I know what we can do. Look at that, food parcels. Something I kept saying we needed, right? For skill points. So let's head over there and let's see if we can steal a helicopter full of food parcels or a truck full of food parcels. There we go. I love the mountains. I love the verticality, the topography. Big words there, I know. And the way that it feels, the way that it plays. What have I got here? Ooh, I got a helicopter. Full of supplies. Supplies! I will stop making that joke eventually. Or not. Let's try and sneak in from over here. Yeah, this looks like the place. And we'll get on just over here where we can't be seen. I know, these guys are really, really dumb. They don't notice the helicopter floating 50 yards away full of crazy American gunmen. But that's just the way the game works. So we'll do what we can to work with it. Let's get a spot where we can just overlook. We don't want to lose this helicopter. Got a sniper there. A dude there, and a dude there. There we go, we got a guy over there. Some intel in that building. Okay, let's swap over to sniper. Is that 127 meters? There won't be hardly any drop for that. Goodbye. Well, goodbye now. I think we're going to do a smash and grab. I'm going to sneak in here. Oh no, he is not. Although I did kill a guy who apparently was surrendering. I don't really care about that. If you kill too many of them in between missions, you can that'll be sort of a mission failed, game over. For the moment, though, I just want the materials in the helicopter. It really feels good to fly the helicopters. They have their own, each of them has their own unique feel of either real light, throw it across the sky kind of thing, or a more meaty, heavy feeling. And we're gonna come in for a landing and see if our friends in Pack 26 or Pack 21, what the heck's it called again? The Rebels. And see if they're grateful for us having stole a whole bunch of stuff for them. Yeah, a little bit of a rough landing, but any landing you can walk away from is a good landing. Bingo. And here's a truck. Or is it a tractor? Oh, it's a tractor. The tractors are so much fun. Here, guys. Just maybe to end this video or to get a little going on, we'll drive a farm tractor. It's remarkably fast considering it's a little farm tractor. It'll go through anything and over anything. Kind of the secret cool stuff. Let's put some skills here, what we said, right? Squad resilience, more resistant to bullet damage, all members. I need at least one point in everything. I don't see a lot of use for this until later in the game, so I won't go too crazy about it. And how about drone, maybe? I don't know. Frag grenades? Do I want frag grenades? I'll let you guys decide. Let me know what I should be working on next. For the moment, I'm going to keep pushing squad skills. I could get a faster revive speed, better trained rebels, longer bleed out time, and more efficiency in my people, which I still don't know what it means. If you have any idea, if you've got some numerical proof that this is a good thing, show me or let me know, or maybe I'll find out. I'll do some research and then I'll do some testing and we'll see what that means and whether or not that skill is worth having, or if you only just grab it because you have to on the way to getting something else. Okay, let's go after this intel here. There we go. And yeah, as silly as it looks, the tractor actually is capable of moving, but I think instead I'm going to steal the helicopter. Once you've landed a helicopter with the materials, you can just go ahead and take it. It doesn't change anything for the mission. The mission's over. That's now just a useful helicopter.
I'm in. Let's go.
And here we go. Yes, I can parachute now, and I will give you a demonstration of the parachute ability. You can base jump off of high cliffs. You can parachute, obviously, out of a vehicle like this. And maybe I'll parachute into this next zone. You see the Unidad stuff on my little mini-map over there on the left. In the blue or purple. Please forgive a poor old colorblind guy who doesn't always know what color he's looking at. And here we go. Parachute! Well, goodbye now. Open the chute. Left and right on the L-pad.
Got some hostile activity.
Let's land it over here in this field. Landing is pretty much a given. Pull back on your stick a bit if you want to slow down. And you're done.
Eyes on a narco with a submachine gun.
All right. Let's pop up a drone and see who's in here and what they're doing. Got spotter up in the tower. Guy over there on that one. Heavy gunner up there. And my intel is in there. Okay, and one up there. This looks like a sharpshooter's paradise. Yeah, you'll notice he almost spotted that.
I don't see him.
Over by the checkpoint.
Okay. Let's get up against this thing here. If we can get an angle on our sharpshooter. Oh, he's a tough shot. Okay, he doesn't seem to see me though. Let's come along the back here.
Check your targets. We got civilians all over the place.
Yes, we do have civilians.
Oh.
Where you got him?
In the HQ building.
Uh-huh.
I got a target carrying submachine guns.
I see. Okay, let's just sneak up here. Take this guy out. There is a melee kill. I'm going to show it to you. You just knock him out. Let's see if we can get a sharpshooter shot across here. I can see a guy in there, but I can't really see him.
Got eyes on a mounted weapon.
We're going to take our time and try not to screw this one up in any way. We're going to treat this like it's a real mission. Not very steady aim with this early sniper rifle. Right through the window. Got him. Very nice. There's somebody down in this building, I think. Tempted to try and take that guy out, but it's a tough shot.
We got a Sicario.
Point him out.
Right by that stack of tires.
Oh. I've got one down here I know about. What about this guy over here? Okay, let's get on the move. We can sit up here all day and just never get a clean shot. I'm not sure who almost spotted me out there, but somebody did. That's how you do it. Got him. Ha ha. Dead center. Good shot. Darn it, I missed.
Fire, fire, fire.
Nice, rebels have shown up to help me. Sorry about being quiet there. I really wanted to get a feel for the stealth and how bad things go when you mess up one shot. Not good for you, definitely. As you can see, it really puts you on the block. Drop that guy right out of his gun, though. I got lucky that the cartel showed up, or not the cartel, the rebels showed up to provide a little support. And let's sneak into here, grab my intel, get on to my next mission. A little ammo never hurts. There we are. I seem to have got most of them, and they don't seem to have brought in any. No, they didn't bring any help. Hey! So you can recover pretty quickly if you're smart. Let's see where the next, where all the weapons in here are.
Shit, we got company.
7 weapon and accessory positions are found in this area. So there's a lot of different things to pick up, a lot of guns. I said things got a little intense there, so I quieted up and gave you the impression of what it is we're trying to do. Here we go. More and more stuff, more and more materials. And here's our mission.
Let's clean up and move on.
Unidad bird on patrol.
Check
watch
it out. Got a location on a cocaine factory operating out of a converted slaughterhouse here in Okoro.
What are we waiting for? Let's go light that shit up.
Just one problem. The factory door requires a key code to open.
So where do we get the code?
According to this, El Emisario's assistant has it. We need to track him down. This is a commendation? Looks like it came from a box of cereal at the Air Force or something.
I love that Air Force joke. Anyone out there in the Air Force, just poking fun. I have nothing but respect for all of the branches of the armed services. You guys do a great job. But it's kind of funny, you got to admit. The inter forces joshing that goes along there. Okay, that's some interesting intel on La Gringa, who's sort of being held here. I guess they have her working biochemistry to figure out better ways to smuggle cocaine, better ways to improve it. Do we have a skill available? 3 squad skills. And do I want it? Yeah, let's grab one more entrained rebels and one more and squad resilience. Why not? By the time we get to level 16, we'll have got more than enough skill points to start building those. We'll see if that makes any difference. And we'll try to do maybe one more thing before I call it. Let's take this helicopter and go get... Ooh, let's go steal a plane full of comm tools. Why not? And I will catch you guys in episode 8, where we will continue on the story mission here in Okoro. And again, just do side missions and the like if they pop up and seem to tickle our fancy. This is very much how the game is meant to be played. You do the things you feel like doing. You don't need the better or the later weapons for a better loadout to take down the enemy, especially not on normal difficulty. Maybe in the harder ones you might want to be a little more picky about your loadouts and, you know, rush skills like getting C4 and EMP on your drone to help take out things. But so far, I mean, I'm not playing amazing, but then I don't play any game amazing. I'm having a good time, and sometimes I get killed. Mostly it's my own fault, though. It's not the fault of the game or the weapons. Here we go. Let's see if we can steal this plane. Flying planes is still is still tricky, let's just say. I'm not going to pretend it's anything more than kind of difficult. Hit them with the mortar. Oh my. They have a mortar. Let's bring this plane in. I like these door guns. But for the moment, I'm just gonna land. That was a nice landing. Getting better. And see if I can sneak in and steal this airplane. Get some more materials, which are very important for building your skills. And skills are important for getting the most out of the game, I think. And it seems to be. As always, if you want to see me play on a harder difficulty, let me know. I'll give it a try. We can laugh, or you can laugh at me fumbling my way around and getting shot every 2 seconds, if that's your idea of a good time. I think we're going to try and sink shot as many of these cabrons as we can. Especially that heavy gunner. And how the hell did I miss that guy? Wow, I was right on him, I thought. That was an obvious miss. The sight has a tendency when you first aim in to suddenly swing over to the right a bit. There is a skill that allows you to get better stability when you're aiming down the sight, and I will probably try and work my way up towards that. I'm not going to be too picky though. Okay, so I'm going to try and fly this plane, and more importantly, try and land this plane at a rebel site for all the gear that it has, and try and up my rating with these guys and get some materials. Flying the plane is no different than flying the helicopter in one way. It's just, you know, R2, pull back on the stick to go up, push forward on the stick to go down. I tend to move my camera first, then you let go of R2, and you get a nice tight turn that way. Who doesn't like a nice tight turn? And 5 kilometers I have to fly this thing, wow. And land it somewhere. I find little movements of the stick is really what you want. Don't go crazy, don't haul it over to one side, you'll roll the darn plane over and be into the ground before you even realize it. You're not going to run out of fuel, so don't be afraid to fly around a couple of times, get a good look at your runway, get a good feel for your runway, line it up just the way you want. Don't ask me why there's suddenly smoke coming off of this thing. I don't remember having hit anything. And here we go. We will try our best to land up on this cliffside airfield. And no, you can't just, you know, parachute over and land. You have to land the plane. This is probably one of the trickiest parts of the game, is landing these airplanes on these landing strips. They don't give you much to work with. I'm going to do one flyover, get an idea of the angle of approach. And see, it's telling me hold the brake and land. Okay, it's not quite as easy as that. So let's get a little distance this way, swing around on an inbound vector. Yes, I'm using big technical words as if I somehow know what they mean. And so what I'll do is I'll turn my camera around, right? And it doesn't last for too long, but I'll turn it around and then I will let go of the stick and do a loop. I love the fact that she said shitballs when she did a loop. There we go. Let's just pull it around like that. Still not sure why there's smoke coming out of my plane. Unless that has to do with the rain. I don't remember having done anything to damage it. Okay, let's bring it in. on an angle like this, see if I can line up with the runway. Oh boy, this is going to be quite the experience. Hit the brakes. Whoa, hit the brakes, buddy, hit the brakes. Ha! Sort of. Yeah, I'll call that one a success.
We're done here.
Good enough. As you can see, it's pretty forgiving. Okay, muchachos and muchachas, I hope you have a happy Easter, a happy Passover, a happy second week of April, whatever it is you celebrate or don't celebrate, no problem with me. Whatever you do, do it with everything you've got and have a great time. I wish you a great day and great gaming. I have been Mighty Mr. Mustache, the mightiest mustache in the universe. Take care.